Hi, this instructional video will teach you the steps required to crack WEP Wi-Fi passwords on most routers. Before we get started, a disclaimer. This guide is for educational purposes only. You should only attempt to crack passwords on a device you own, or with the express consent of the owner. Failing to do so can constitute a crime in many countries. Flashrouters is not responsible or liable for any misuse of the information contained in this guide. To follow this guide, you will require three things. Number one, a Wi-Fi enabled router configured to use WEP security. I'll be using an ASUS RT-N66U router running Tomato firmware, but this technique will work with just about any router using any firmware. Number two, a Wi-Fi card that supports Linux drivers and packet injection. You can look online for a list of supported devices. Most likely your built-in card does not support this capability. I'm using the TP-Link TL-WN722N Wi-Fi USB adapter. It's small, portable, and cheap. I recommend the high-gain model as this will give you a greater range. Finally, you'll need a Linux operating system. This guide assumes you are using Debian or a Debian-based distribution such as Ubuntu. Any distro should work, but the exact command line syntax may vary slightly. Once your environment is configured, we can start the cracking procedure. First, we need to place our Wi-Fi adapter into monitoring mode. Do this by running airmon-ng start WAN0. Notice that monitor mode is now enabled on mon0 interface. This is what we're going to be using for the rest of our commands. Before we can go further, we'll need to record some information. First, we need our host MAC address. Run the ifconfig command and note the MAC address listed under WLAN0. Next, we need some information about our target router. Run /ng --encrypt-wep-mon0. Let it run for a couple seconds. It will record all WEP secured routers within range. My router is called CrackTest. When you see your router listed, you can press the Control plus C key to kill the command. Write down the BSS ID, channel, and ESS ID for your router. Now we need to capture and record some data. Run the command /ng --c --, the channel number of your router, --BSS ID, your router's BSS ID number, -W output, mon0, which is again our monitoring Wi-Fi interface. You're going to let this run continuously while we open up a couple other commands and run them at the same time. Next, we need to fake authentication with our router. To do this, run the following command: airreplay-ng-10-e, the name of your Wi-Fi router, which in this case is CrackTest, -a, the BSS ID of the router, -h, the host MAC address of our interface, and then our interface mon0. You'll notice when I ran this command, I got an error telling me that I need to add this switch, ignore -1. This is because of a bug in my kernel drivers. You can either patch this or just add the -ignore -1 command at the end. If it succeeds, you should get an association successful notification as well as a smiley face at the bottom. Now we can start listening for ARP requests and re-inject them. Do this by running the command airreplay-ng-3-b, your router's BSS ID number, -h, your host MAC address. If you need to, use the ignore -1 patch again, and then finally the mon0 interface. Let this run for a while. What we're looking for is a rapid increase in the amount of ARP requests that we're seeing. Sometimes it takes a couple seconds until they start to show up, so just hang tight. In some cases, after a while, you still may not see any ARP requests being generated. There are advanced techniques to generate the data, such as chop-chop and fragmentation, but we won't be covering them here. Continue to let this command run and open up another terminal. Now we're ready for the last step. run the following command, aircrack-ng-b, the name of your BSS ID, output *.cap, and hit enter. If you generated enough data, this should run very quickly. Otherwise, it can take a few seconds to a minute. But when it's finished, you'll see that we've successfully found our WEP key. This can now be used to connect to our router. We just need to remove the colons, and we're all set to go. Congratulations. How can you protect yourself from an attack this simple? Well, first of all, you should never ever use WEP security under any circumstances. WPA and WPA2 security should always be used instead. There are some flaws in the way that many vendors implement WPA, which can make it equally as dangerous. An open source firmware such as DDWRT or Tomato that comes installed on all flash routers is a simple and effective way to mitigate all known WEP and WPA attacks.
Flash routers. Better routers, better internet.